been kicking the can down the road. And as more baby boomers retire, the question is, will there still be that social safety net? Let's talk about with our friend Stephen Kent from Young Voices Up Late with me on the Final Five. Good to see you, Stephen.
Good to see you, Jim.
Why should we care about this? We pay into Social Security. It's going to be there when we retire years and years from now, right?
Yeah, well, it probably won't come as a surprise to you that most young people, millennials, people under 35, are not expecting to ever see a Social Security check. Most recently, according to a survey from Transamerica in 2018, 80% of millennials aren't ever going to see it. But there is a short-term reason why we should be really concerned about this. Lawmakers who are more inclined to tax and spend to solve difficult problems, they want to solve this shortfall in Social Security by increasing the payroll tax by 0.1% every year until it reaches 14%. This is really bad news for people like me, people like you, who are already trying to do things like pay off their student debts, live in increasingly expensive cities, and already, you know, kind of move from job to job on the regular. Our odds of saving money for our own purposes is going to be in decline very quick if that's going to be the solution.
You know, they said for years, and I think back to 2000, the infamous Al Gore lockbox mantra that he repeated when it came to Social Security. But the reality is, this is not meant to be a sole retirement income. This is meant to be that safety net out there. The problem is, you mentioned higher cost of living out there, tougher to find jobs. It's really hard to build up that nest egg, and people find themselves thinking that Social Security is going to be there. You know, our parents. And the reality is it's quickly dwindling.
Yeah, well, the world is very different than it was in 1935 when Social Security was signed into law by President FDR. It was devised for a workforce that looks nothing like what we have today. Back in 1935, only 24% of women were in the workforce. Today, that is 73%. Life expectancy is up to 79 from where it was at 64. And one quarter of the workforce back then in 35 worked in agriculture. This is just a completely different world that we live in now. And we're going to have to start thinking about what needs to change about Social Security to uphold the social contract that it is meant to fulfill if it is going to stay in existence and continue to dole out benefits to people who need it.
Yeah. So as we move forward here and as we look in the years to come, I mean, it's still pretty limited. What we pay in, and I know people out there, we are paying into Social Security week by week, day by day. There's a cap in which you're done paying into Social Security. In fact, you reach a max. You're not putting any more money into it. So what do you do? How do you fix this?
Well, there are a couple ways that you could fix this. I am of the belief that Congress is going to need to readdress the purpose of Social Security and actually reformat it to be a safety net program for those who are in the most need when they reach the age of 65 and pursue retirement. Right now, everyone from your average auto mechanic who makes $35,000 a year to the Koch brothers to millionaire Bernie Sanders and Oprah are going to be getting checks in the mail for Social Security. How does that make sense? That makes no sense.
But if you still pay into the program, isn't there an expectation that you're going to get something out of it?
Well, that's been the status quo since 1935, but it's not going to work. The math doesn't add up. The level of need is not the same. And I think this is as good a time as any to consider if we're going to have a Social Security program to help people be comfortable in retirement, why are we doling out benefits to people who don't actually need those checks to be comfortable in retirement?
So who's talking about this right now? Because we have 2020 ahead of us. You have so many candidates, including one who entered the race today, who could be drawing Social Security checks.
Yeah.
But you know, I heard a lot of people talking about this in 2000. George W. Bush said, why don't we let people put money into the stock market? That didn't happen. I mean, is that something that could work, that Republican plan from years ago? Or is anybody talking about this?
No. So Washington, D.C., as you know, is very different than it was back in 2000. In the George Bush years, they were concerned with trying to do that. They also wanted to try to introduce a transparency act for Social Security so that people could see more clearly on their pay stubs how much they were paying into it, because it's actually more than most people think. There is no desire or political will on the part of modern day Republicans or Democrats to touch this for different reasons, but they both serve older constituencies, and they are very much tied to it. Donald Trump really moved against the Republican consensus in D.C. of like the Paul Ryans of the world,
right,
by making entitlements and Social Security something that he ran on protecting. That is a huge shift in Beltway Republican orthodoxy, but that's kind of the point. We're seeing that voters across the aisle, red and blue, expect to receive what they paid into.
Yeah.
The problem is that they're not going to get all of it unless we make sacrifices.
And those older Americans are the ones who still vote on a reliable basis, and that's why they say Social Security is like the third rail of politics. You just don't touch it. Stephen, yeah, good to see you, my friend.